Hello, my name is Andrii Domanskyi. I'm senior research scientist at Orion Pharma, working in Turku in Finland. And today we'll be talking with you about alpha-synuclein aggregation in Parkinson's disease, which is rather big topic and sometimes even controversial topic in Parkinson's disease field. During this talk, we will discuss problems in developing disease-modifying therapies and also current therapeutic strategies related to Parkinson's disease treatment. We also talk about animal models and the benefits and limitations of modeling alpha-synuclein pathology in dopamine neurons with preformed fibrils. So I hope that by the end of the presentation you will meet those learning objectives and you can have some idea about what we are doing. I will be talking about those models which we are actually currently using in some of our projects in Orion Pharma and also at the University of Helsinki where I used to work and still actually working. Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is neurodegenerative disorder, as you probably know, with severe motor symptoms like bradykinesia, difficulty to move, tremor in the hands, and this has been described by John Parkinson some 100 years ago. And the motor symptoms are caused by the loss of specific neuronal population in the midbrain, dopaminergic neurons. Also, other neuronal populations are affected. Around 10 million patients are worldwide, and of course, it's a big market for drug companies to develop anti-Parkinsonian drugs. Unfortunately, currently, there is only symptomatic treatment for the Parkinson's disease, which has a great benefit for patients. However, it does not stop progression of the disease. And with time, those symptoms get worsened and patients need to be treated with different treatments. And since there is no disease-modifying treatment, this has been actually a holy grail for Parkinson's disease field to find the disease-modified treatment. At the end of the lecture, we can actually have a look with you a little bit about what are current options and strategies to find the disease-modified treatment for Parkinson's disease. Dopaminergic neurons, back to symptoms of and also the causes of Parkinson's disease symptoms. So dopamine system in the human brain is depicted in this slide. And specifically, Parkinson's disease symptoms are caused by selective death of dopamine neurons in so-called substantia nigra. So these neurons on the section of the human brain, you can see for your right side, of course, my right, is depicted the human brain sections with neurons having neuromelanin, and therefore they are black. That's why this area is called black substance, substantia nigra. So these neurons are specifically lost in Parkinson's disease patients, leading to cardinal motor symptoms. The loss of dopaminergic neurons and progression of dopaminergic neurons for Parkinson's disease is accompanied by appearance of insoluble protein inclusions in different neuronal populations throughout the brain. Those neuronal inclusions have been described already more than 100 years ago by German pathologist Heinrich Lewy, who noticed that in brains of patients there are some neuronal inclusions in different neuronal populations. These inclusions have different morphology depending on the area where they are observed. There are some different ones in brainstem, and there are also in cortical regions. And for many years, it was not clear what are those neuronal what are those Lewy bodies are consisting of. Here you can see the staining of these new Lewy bodies in different populations in different stages of disease progression, and also electron microscopy pictures of this of this inclusion. As I said, another development in understanding of Lewy bodies has been shown by Heiko Brack and colleagues, who by studying many brain sections from multiple Parkinson's disease patients noticed that actually Lewy appearance of Lewy bodies in the brain is progressing throughout in many cases, not in all patients, but in many patients in many brain sections. It actually correlates with disease progression and severity of the disease. And so we can see that, for example, in this diagram, at early stages of the disease, there are only few regions which are affected by Lewy pathology, whereas with the time, Lewy bodies actually appear through the brainstem and also from olfactory bulbs, covering more and more areas in the brain of the patient. So, for many years still, it was not clear what are the components of this Lewy body, so what are they made of. It was clear that there are some protein fragments and also membrane fragments, lipids, but it was not clear which proteins are there. And in 1998, by work of Maria Spivantini and colleagues, they demonstrated that one of the main components of Lewy bodies is a protein called alpha-synuclein. Has been demonstrated by basically having specific antibodies immune staining for the patient's brain. It's also clear that while alpha-synuclein is the main component, there are also other proteins included in participating in Lewy bodies, such as ubiquitin. And recent electron microscopy studies have demonstrated also the presence of membranous inclusions, so parts of membranous organelles, broken mitochondrial parts, as well as lysosomal parts of the in the Lewy body. While Lewy bodies are abundantly observed in Parkinson's disease patients, Parkinson's disease is not the only disease where Lewy bodies are observed. For example, the Lewy bodies are also observed with dementia, with Lewy bodies, which is has a little bit different symptoms to Parkinson's disease, as well as a multiple system atrophy, where these protein inclusions are observed in oligodendrocytes. But in all these diseases, the main component of one of the major components of this inclusions is actually alpha-synuclein. It's also true that there is some percentage of people who are healthy, have Lewy bodies in their brain, but do not develop symptoms, and this inclusion is called incidental Lewy bodies. One of the big progresses in our understanding of Lewy body progression has come from studies when the researchers analyzed grafted neurons which have been transplanted to the brains of Parkinson's disease patients somewhat 20 to 30 years ago in an attempt to restore dopaminergic system function, dopamine system function in their brains. And when these people eventually died and the brains came to autopsy, it has been found that Lewy bodies are also appearing, of course, in the diseased brain, but also some of the transplanted neurons also have alpha-synuclein positive in ubiquitin positive insoluble protein inclusion, suggesting that this pathology is actually transmitted, has been transmitted from diseased neurons to transplanted neurons, which with grafted neurons, which has been actually younger neurons, so 16 to 18, in this case it's actually 16 years old neurons, and still they have this containing this some of those neurons still contain this Lewy body. So there came a hypothesis of prion-like spread of Lewy bodies in the brain, which is consistent with the hypothesis of Bragg, which I showed you a few slides before, when Lewy body spread with disease progression. And it has been actually directly demonstrated in animal models, where in actually several studies. One of the studies I have shown you here, where Lewy body extracts from patient brains, they were prepared and directly injected to mice or monkeys, and they are able to see aggregation of proteins, alpha-synuclein in particular, and cause appearance of this insoluble protein inclusions after injections of Lewy body extracts from patients to the brain of mice and monkeys, leading to dysfunction of dopaminergic system, drop of striatal dopamine, loss of tyrosine hydroxylase positive neurons. So tyrosine hydroxylase is a marker of dopamine neurons. This is an enzyme which is critical for the synthesis of dopamine in this neuronal population. And the drop of this. So by injecting Lewy body extracts from Parkinson's disease patients, one can recapitulate Lewy body pathology in mice and monkeys. And what is more, interesting, relevant, is that when these Lewy body extracts were treated with alpha-synuclein antibodies, and so that alpha-synuclein was selectively depleted from this extract, these extracts then lost their seeding activity. So in a way, the pathology of this extract was dependent on the presence of alpha-synuclein in them. So this suggested that the agent which is responsible for seeding this pathology is actually misfolded alpha-synuclein. And indeed, multiple later studies confirmed this hypothesis. So what is alpha-synuclein? Alpha-synuclein is 140 amino acid, also relatively small protein, and which is natively unfolded, which is ubiquitously expressed in the human brain and also animal brain. It's encoded by alpha-synuclein gene, SNCA. And it is associated with membranes, it can bind membrane, and is participating in synaptic transmission and facilitating fusion of synaptic vesicles with plasma membrane. Genetic studies confirm that some of Parkinson's disease patients have mutations or triplications in alpha-synuclein gene, and so these mutations many cases they promote misfolding of alpha-synuclein, leading to early onset familial Parkinson's disease. It's a small percentage of Parkinson's disease patients, but it's actually further highlighting the importance of alpha-synuclein for Parkinson's disease pathology. And so the increase of alpha-synuclein with, as shown in this genetic study, in this human genetics, but also in multiple animal models, lead to increase of aggregation, also mutations which are stimulating alpha-synuclein aggregation, leads to depletion of or downregulation of autophagy, so the cell is trying to cope with misfolded proteins but eventually fails, and then accumulation of this misfolded protein can actually cause cellular stress, eventually leading to degeneration of dopaminergic neurons. Or such hypothesis is actually being proposed. And therefore, one of the conclusions from this hypothesis would be the idea that if we can reduce the levels of alpha-synuclein or reduce the levels of misfolded alpha-synuclein or promote degradation of misfolded alpha-synuclein species, then we can actually protect the dopamine neurons in Parkinson's disease patients, delaying or preventing their death and therefore developing disease-modifying therapy to slow down progression of Parkinson's disease. And indeed, by multiple studies in different animal models and also in human brain samples, a following model of Lewy body formation has been proposed. So when we have alpha normal conditions in physiological state, unfolded alpha-synuclein, so alpha-synuclein existing in its native configuration, or it binds to synaptic vesicles or some other membranes in cells, and it does not aggregate. Whereas when alpha-synuclein levels are increased, or its propensity to aggregate is affected by genetic mutation, it starts to activate also misfolded proteins, and it also can see the template misfolding of itself so appearance of this misfolded species, misfolded oligomer, actually can recruit them properly folded alpha-synuclein into misfolded conformation, leading to the appearance of this alpha-synuclein aggregate. Then it also, those misfolded fibrils or misfolded oligomers, they can, of course, with their maturation, they can also acquire other proteins and membranes, lipids, as alpha-synuclein can interact also with lipids, eventually leading to Lewy body formation. And so this aggregation is first initiated, and then appearance of this large molecular weight aggregate would lead to eventually formation of Lewy bodies. But this process is actually taking quite some time, and therefore it also explains why it quite slowly progresses. So Parkinson's disease is quite slowly progressing age-related disorder. It also became clear that lysosomes play an important role in the maturation and formation of those Lewy bodies. As I said, the current hypothesis states that of course, cell is trying to cope with misfolded protein, trying to degrade those misfolded protein by lysosomal autophagy pathway. And eventually, when this process fails, it leads to not only accumulation of misfolded alpha-synuclein, but of course a general cellular stress due to failure of autophagy process, and indeed mutations in genes or polymorphism in genes involved in lysosomal function have been shown to predispose patients towards development of Parkinson's disease. It's also also post-translational modifications of alpha-synuclein, such as phosphorylation, truncation, as well as ubiquitination, has been shown to affect its propensity to aggregate and is associated with Lewy body formation. One of such modifications is actually phosphorylation of serine 129 of alpha-synuclein, which is occurring in misfolded forms of alpha-synuclein, and is actually used very frequently as a marker of misfolded alpha-synuclein in research and also in clinical studies. So in many cases we are looking at alpha-synuclein phosphorylation as a proxy of misfolded alpha-synuclein. And so not only the Lewy bodies can form, but also as has been shown in those transplant studies, but also in direct studies in animal models. So this misfolded protein, misfolded alpha-synuclein, can actually propagate from cell to cell, feeding those aggregations not only from in donor cell, but also in acceptor cells. And there are several paths, several ways of how those misfolded alpha-synuclein can be propagated from cell to cell, including passive diffusion and also tunneling nanotubes, for example. Recently, one of the publications specifically looked at the propagation of alpha-synuclein through those tunneling nanotubes, actually involving, also demonstrating that lysosomes are essentially involved in this process, as well as transmission by through extracellular vesicles, which also can be used as a biomarker for Parkinson's disease progression, or at least actively studied as a possible biomarker for Parkinson's disease progression. So the appearance of alpha-synuclein in brain-derived extracellular vesicles, for example. And so from synaptic contact as well. So there have been several pathways suggested for misfolded alpha-synuclein propagating between the cells, including, of course, also receptor-mediated interaction and endocytosis. And so, our understanding of alpha-synuclein propagation has been seriously aided by the development of preformed alpha-synuclein fibrils, which can be expressed either. So alpha-synuclein is isolated in vitro from bacteria. Those fibrils of alpha-synuclein can be incubated to aggregate. And then when these fibrils are added to cells, you can actually recapitulate the process of feeding alpha-synuclein pathology and formation of Lewy bodies, or Lewy body-like structures in cultured neurons can be, and also cell lines, but in primary neurons, in dopaminergic neurons, for example, something which we have been doing in hippocampal neurons, but also in human dopamine neurons derived from patients induced pluripotent stem cells. And essentially, this process allows us to study different stages of Lewy body formation, model formation, and also find the ways to interfere with this pathology. So there are several steps, as I mentioned also on previous slides. So this misfolded alpha-synuclein fibrils can be produced in vitro and then added to cells, internalized, processed by, to which the cells actually process them by lysosome, partial hydrolysis, and then they're released from lysosomal by lysosomal membrane permeabilization. They're released to cytoplasm, recruit endogenous alpha-synuclein, and eventually leading to the appearance of Lewy body-like structures in the cell. So, using this model, has been demonstrated. So, if we actually, scientists from, for example, Hilalashvili lab in Switzerland, has been demonstrated that prolonged incubation or prolonged treatment with these fibrils and cells and cultures is actually leading to Lewy body formation is one of the major drivers of neurodegeneration in this Mogul system. We, in Orion, for example, in many scientists, therefore, it allowed these preformed fibrils, allowed us to model, as I mentioned, Lewy body formation and models at least some aspects of Parkinson disease pathology in culture, in a dish, using different cell types. It can be neurons. It's also, initially studying these neurons, but now Gaze progressing to actually include also other cell types like astrocytes and very recently also microglia, human iPS-derived neurons. Development of midbrain organoids, which can also be treated with preformed alpha-synuclein fibrils, inducing alpha-synuclein pathology, formation of Lewy body-like structures. And of course, we can also treat them. So we can use the systems to study the effects of small molecules as well as other interfering proteins like antisense oligonucleotides or antibodies which very recently developed actually in clinical trials, in phase 2 clinical trials. Currently there is a treatment antibody which is binding alpha-synuclein and depleting alpha-synuclein from Parkinson's disease patients, specifically misfolded alpha-synuclein, preventing spread of misfolded alpha-synuclein between cells. It remains to be seen if this will be a successful strategy. But it appears that targeting alpha-synuclein is actually a very promising strategy for developing disease-modifying for Parkinson's disease. In our studies at the University of Helsinki, using this model, we, for example, demonstrated that a neurotrophic factor, GDNF, can reduce accumulation of alpha-synuclein aggregate in mouse embryonic dopaminergic neuron. Going to in vivo model, again, these preformed fibrils, they can be injected to the brain of rodents and actually also primates, as I've been showing previously for Lewy body extracts, but also preformed fibrils injected to different brain regions, inducing alpha-synuclein aggregation. These fibrils can be used either alone or in combination with again associated viral vectors to overexpress alpha-synuclein, actually induce alpha-synuclein aggregation in mouse brain or rodent brain, actually rat brain. One of such models has been recently published and developed by Malling Parmer and group of Malling Parmer in Lund University, where they combine the alpha-synuclein overexpressing gene-associated viral vectors with preformed fibrils, which is inducing robust degeneration of dopamine neurons with some behavioral phenotype. Again, underlining or like highlighting the importance of alpha-synuclein in this process, are the following studies where injection of those fibrils to alpha-synuclein knockout mice does not lead to the development of Lewy body pathology, demonstrating that alpha-synuclein appears to be a crucial factor necessary for the development of pathology in animal models and, well, as well as in human iPS-derived cells in some other studies. And, well, so as an example of how this can be applied, so those in vivo models can actually also be applied for development of disease-modifying strategies in Parkinson's disease. So very recently it has been published by studies of antisense oligonucleotides actually targeting alpha-synuclein, reducing alpha-synuclein levels in the brain of mice. It's been demonstrated that such antisense oligonucleotides can prevent or at least attenuate formation of aggregates in fibril-injected rodents with alpha-synuclein aggregation. So altogether, alpha-synuclein preformed alpha-synuclein fibril model, allowing us to address multiple aspects of alpha-synuclein and Lewy body formation and alpha-synuclein cell-to-cell transmission, initiation of misfolding, progression, so cellular pathways related to processing of misfolded alpha-synuclein, related to lysosomal functions, and of course also cell-to-cell propagation of alpha-synuclein. As I mentioned now, also the importance of other cellular types in addition to neurons is actively recognized, and those co-culture systems are actively used to model some aspects of alpha-synuclein pathology in the brain, which allows us to test drug candidates in preclinical studies. And, well, of course, alpha-synuclein aggregation is being a central part in my current hypothesis of pathology progression is not the only part in which predisposes or believed to predispose neurons to degenerate with aging. There is also like mitochondrial dysfunction and oxidative stress and autophagy impairment, which is actually not necessary in the case of these processes are actually interdependent. So like alpha-synuclein misfolding can cause impairment of autophagy, or autophagy impairment can cause actually alpha-synuclein aggregation. It's also, I did not touch this, so we've touched the cell-to-cell propagation, but also there is a current hypothesis that actually, at least in some patients, transmission of alpha-synuclein aggregation, or alpha-synuclein aggregation may initiate in the gut and then, progress to the brain of patients by transmission of pathology. All of these pathways are actively studied to find or at least try to get an idea about possible disease-modified treatments. And multiple agents, multiple drugs are currently being studied for Parkinson's disease in various stages of clinical trials, which, for example, has been recently, very recently reviewed, but also last year. So basically, well, every year, there are multiple drugs, coming to the clinical trials, but unfortunately, also multiple treatments, failing clinical trials, as you can see here on this slide. There are many drugs which have been discontinued due to low efficacy or some kind of side effects. So in respect to alpha-synuclein aggregation, perhaps the most, one of the very promising development is the development, for example, of those antibodies specifically interacting with misfolded alpha-synuclein protein, which block its progression, block its transmission, and is currently in phase 2 clinical trials, as well as, as I showed you in a few slides before, those antisense oligonucleotides, which are reducing alpha-synuclein levels. It remains to be seen if this process, these treatments would be beneficial or would actually lead to disease-modifying effect. But at least currently, alpha-synuclein and misfolded alpha-synuclein appears to be one of the best candidates for development of such treatments. And preformed fibrils have been very instrumental in our understanding of alpha-synuclein progression and from processes of alpha-synuclein misfolding. With that, I thank you very much for your attention, and I would like to finish my talk by saying that it's work in progress, and many questions remain unanswered, but we hope that with the current years, the development will be successful. Thank you very much, and thank you for your attention.